Stay there. All right. Hiya, folks. Well, as you can see, we've got Merlin and Dougal here, and bit of bad news, I'm afraid. This week we lost Barney, I'm afraid. We had to take him to the vet. He wasn't too well at all, and we had to have him put to sleep. So these two now are on their own with us, and as you can see, they're still giving us a lot of loving and stuff like that, but it was very sad. He went downhill pretty quickly. We noticed his back legs had gone. He had very bad diarrhea. He had his breath got very, very bad for some reason, very quickly.
He just smelt, didn't he?
And he really smelt a lot. And as I say, his back legs totally went. And he lost his sort of spirit. You could see he lost his sort of spirit. So we'd seen it coming for a while, although we hadn't said nothing about it. We had seen it coming for a while, but
he was 13, wasn't
he? He was 13, just turned 13, Barney, as I say. But he did go downhill.
His eyes had gone, his ears.
His eyes, he couldn't hear anything. And it was, you know, when you know it's their time sort of thing. So we've now got to concentrate on these two. And unfortunately, they've both got diarrhoea at the moment, Sharon, haven't they?
I don't know. We've had not a bad light last night, so hopefully we've turned the corner with them.
Yeah, so hopefully we've got them back on the chappy again. They do. Merlin, he picks up anything, doesn't he, Shao?
Yeah, anyone got any good tips to stop the dog picking up things? He's got toys and that.
But he just picks stuff up, and it's stuff he shouldn't be chewing. I know he's a puppy, and it's going to happen.
Yeah, but we forgot.
Dougal is a different dog altogether. He's a bit more mature, isn't he, Shao?
In fact, he has pinched the odd thing. I've seen him pinch the odd thing too, but nothing like him. He's still young as well at the end of the day. He's only two.
Anyway, let's leave these two here for a minute. I'll show you.
Leave us three.
Leave these three, rather. I've been buying lawnmowers again, folks, so you'll see them come up on there.
Dogs the other month, didn't
I? I just buy things in bulk, shall I? Right, let's have a look outside. Look, Lily's pulling her top. Look, Merlin.
Merlin, no!
Sit down. Merlin, no. Sit. 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 Stand, Merlin, stand. He does listen and play.
He does.
He's in a playful mood, Sharon, look.
Yeah, this is a mad half hour.
Yeah, well, I'm going to have a mad half hour outside, Sharon. So we're a little bit busy at the moment, even though it's a lousy day out here. Let's get outside for a minute, shall we? I've still got that garden fence to sort out, but I've been working on cars all week, haven't I, shall
we? Here they go.
Here they go,
look. Where's your toys?
He's a bit weary, that thing you got over there, shall we? Merlin, Dougal, look. He's gone over it again, look. That's, what's it called? A flamingo, isn't it? So that's that. I've just picked this up off of a Facebook Marketplace, folks. Totally complete. And, it just wants a good clean up, I think. This would be an easy flip, this one. I pay £15 for this, folks.
Hey? Well, this time of year.
What won't? What?
Easy flip.
No, well, even if I store this till next year. What I'll do is I'll take this cover off and I'll sandblast that and powder coat it. Is that plastic or metal? That's okay, so that's all right. The deck just needs a good polish up. Plenty of tread left on the wheels, as you can see, so I'm well happy with that. And it's got a good grass box. The only other thing I think it needs is a couple of these knobs. You know them spinning knobs, them sort of things there, look. So someone just put a couple of bolts through there. But I've probably got a couple of them in stock somewhere. So I haven't tried to start it yet. I won't do that. I'll be doing that on the other video. But yeah, so you just look out for stuff like this. This time of year, we're in mid-October at the moment, and the cutting season's over. People just want to get rid of stuff. So that's what I've picked up there. And over here, this was another one I've picked up. Again, I'll pay £20 for this one. In fact, the other one, the £15 one's in better condition than that one, to be honest with you. But again, I'll just tinker on with them, and they'll be ready to sell back next February, something like that. And they'll look immaculate when I finish them, because I love tinkering about. So yeah, it's a bit poxy weather out here at the moment. So what are you doing, baby? What are you doing? I've still got my scooter there, folks. So I'll probably hang on to that till next spring now, because even though it's got all legal and MOT tax and insured and all that, I'll probably just keep hold of that for a moment.
What's this little mower here?
That one? That's another one there, that's one of Gary's.
Dumping ground.
I've just got to take the carb off of that, because it did eventually, after I started it not so long back. We've had this one for about a month now.
Should that be in his polytunnel?
Baby, when he comes round, you can tell him that, can't you?
I will be.
You tell him that. But that one needs the float sorting out, Sharon. You know what's the matter with it? The needle valve, shall? He's punching one out.
Yeah,
look at it. You can study his motion in
it
a minute.
It looks a bit more solid.
The needle valve's letting by on the carb.
I don't really give two hoots.
And then what's the symptom of that?
Nothing, get rid
of it. The fuel tank, no, not get rid of it, shall? Fix it.
Somebody's got rid of it.
The fuel tank empties, right? and the fuel leaks out through the carb into the air filter, makes the air filter a bit sodden, and it drips onto the deck.
I'm bored of that.
Oh, of course you are. You'd rather look at his poo, wouldn't you?
I would, yeah. I've lost it.
Yeah, that's because the grass needs cutting, shall
I? I've actually lost it.
I don't know. Yeah, I'm not cutting that grass in this weather, sure. It's too damp. Anyway, I ain't got a decent lawnmower. Sharon.
That's right.
Hey? Anyway.
What's that?
Mind you, don't tread in it, shall, because the grass is quite long.
Go back to where we stood.
Well, I'll tell you what, you crouch and I'll see if I can get the same image. Go
on. don't
What's he got?
In.
What's he got now? Merlin, come here. Come here.
Oh, Mark, you should have let me
come here. Come here, Merlin. Come here. Good boy. Drop it. Merlin, look, drop it.
Ah, there it is.
Let go. Dougal, what about you, mate? Eh?
Mark, that's nearly solid.
Eh? What, Dougal? You good boy. Eh? What's it, Shell? Squat, Shell, so I can get a picture of where it is.
It's nearly solid.
Unbelievable. You're not having that, Merlin. I'm putting that up.
Well,
the chat, I told you.
I don't know who that person was, but thank you so much for that advice. And if you're watching, if you wouldn't mind commenting, do we keep him on Chappy now?
What?
Because I brought him a dried food for large dogs.
Yeah.
And I think they've had some sort of bug, all of them.
Yeah, look, that's what he does, folks. Look. See, look at that. Look, what a crafty git. Look, he's got it back again, look. And that's why you've got to be so careful, Shell, in the kitchen, haven't you? He's going to chew that and get the shit, Shell. Yeah? Good girl. Now, before, see, that shows how he's getting better, Shell, because normally he'd run away, wouldn't he?
Yeah.
Do you want to sit down, Shell? When I get that gazebo built, you can put these all underneath,
Shell. I've actually got somebody had a boat, and they got in their boat, and they still had the sail, so that's waterproof, and I took that, because she was going to take it to see if I said, no, I wrapped my chairs up in it, inside the gazebo, but...
What sail? Is that the thing in the back of Jimmy's car?
No, in the back of your... Reliant it is, it's all folded up.
Oh, is that what that is?
Yeah.
I wonder what that was. I thought that was...
It's like canvas, and I thought you can't get any stronger than that to wrap them up in.
Yeah, oh, okay. All right then, well...
chuck those things away. We are restored.
Get rid of that, shall. I can't restore that little bit of log.
Yeah.
In you go. Come put the kettle on, baby.
I did actually, come out.
Come on, let's go inside. I can't get motivated out here today, shall. It's too wet. He had the remote control. Now, you saw how big he was when he jumped up on that table there.
He can actually reach, oh, you can't really see, the windowsill now.
Yeah, well, she had the habit, and I kept telling her, I have to train her as well as the dog. She was putting stuff out of reach, what she thinks out of reach at the back. Of course, he can sniff it out, can't he? And he's up there, and he's putting his paw, you see the way he done his paw already on? Anyway, so we got the two remote controls, the one for the TV and the one for the soundbar, stuck on the back of each other. With some Velcro. Anyway, we heard a crunch. He's blinking chewed it and he's chewed the remote control. The little one for the soundbar is only about that big. That cost 15 quid. So bought a brand new one. He said, right, every time we watch telly now, we leave the room, we've got to put it on the shelf. We done it, but you're going
to
forget.
Well, we come out for dinner, didn't we, to do dinner?
Shout, it's after your bluggles. We come out to do dinner. Next thing we see, he's got the remote control in his mouth again, hasn't he? The new one. He's done the same again, so he's cost us 30 quid in remote controls at the moment within a space of a week. Yeah. So I've picked up a couple of lawnmowers. I didn't intend on doing it, but I do hear a lot of people say, oh, we can't get no lawnmowers. I wish we had the resources you have to pick up lawnmowers and all that. Well, we used to buy them at auction and stuff like that. We used to go to auctions on a regular basis, me and Sharon, and we used to pick them up for like £5 there. But the next best place we found is Facebook Marketplace. I don't know what anyone says about it. I know there's a lot of people looking for them, but this one had been on for 18 hours, I think it was on. And I just happened to text the bloke last night and said that, is it still for sale? If it is, I'll have it. And he messaged me back, 5:15 this morning, saying, yeah, that's fine, blah, blah, blah. So we just been round there and picked it up at sort of 9:30 in the morning. And within a 14-mile radius it was, so yeah, 14 miles away. So they are out there, the bargains, and you know, just
quick though, isn't you?
You have got to be quick, Shab. As I said, I was doubtful for that price, £15, and seeing it was all complete and it didn't have any holes in the decks, and it looks like it just needed a good clean up, to be honest with you.
Can you just move forward for a second?
I thought that I wouldn't stand a chance, but there you go, I got it. So what are you doing today, babe? What have we got
making
for dinner?
Your cauliflower cheese. We've got short river beef.
Short river beef?
Yeah.
Oh, I love that. So she makes cauliflower cheese, Sharon. And we get a fresh cauliflower, although you can buy it. No, you can't buy it, can you?
Yes, I think you can in the fridges, yeah.
Oh, right, yeah, we like it fresh. And what we've started doing, Sharon, tell them about what we have. It's Chinese curry. Mm. We had a prawn curry, didn't we? And rather than have rice, because we're low carbs, we're not doing strictly keto, but we're virtually no carbs. If we do have carbs, normally it comes from our vegetables. And what do you do when you do a cauliflower rice, don't you?
I just put this in the food processor.
Yep.
And it makes the rice in the grating bit.
Yep.
And then I just put olive oil in the frying pan, add this all.
When it's all like
made to rice, the cauliflower rice. Cook that for a bit, and then I whisk an egg up and put an egg in, and then you've got egg fried rice.
And if you eat that with your curry, you can't tell the difference, Sharon.
And I'll tell you, if you like Chinese curry.
Oh, here we go.
Cheats way. But this is it. It is Chinese curry, I'm sorry.
You turn them low lights on, Sharon, down there. So we can see.
I highly recommend this.
Right.
I think it's £1 a box.
Show the lights glaring, that's it there. So that's £1 a box where you get it from. And it gives you the authentic Chinese curry flavour, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And you whacked prawns with that the other day, and it was just like eating what we've had in
onions and peas.
Onions and peas. Put onions and peas with it as well. Chopped onions and peas with your prawns or chicken. You do it with chicken.
I've done it with chicken. I've done it with any meat that's left over.
Yeah. And that makes an absolutely lovely curry.
It's the Chinese style curry.
Chinese style curry, yeah. And with this, as I say, that in the food processor, blend it up till it's in little small bits. Fry it off in the frying pan, as she says.
Or just grate it if you haven't got a food processor.
Or you could grate it.
Yeah.
What did you say?
That's all I've done was heated some olive oil up in the pan.
And then throw a couple of eggs in.
Yeah, nearly
when
it's done.
And then stir it all up in the frying pan. And that acts as your rice.
Yeah.
And you're eating a meal, you're very, very low in carbs, because this has got virtually no carbs in it whatsoever. Happy days, folks.
So this is Martin's favourite. He loves cauliflower cheese.
Cauliflower cheese, yep. Again, you can
eat it. He will have that instead of potatoes.
Yes,
see?
That's what I do. You're going loopy, aren't you? Aren't you? You're going loopy? What have you got here, look? What have we got for you in here? They like these little meatballs here, look. I'll just give them one each, yeah. Just give them one each. These little things, we get these from Aldi.
See, I'm wondering, man, when I went dog training with him in that field, whether he's picked something up.
Well, he might have done, Sharon.
Yeah.
You took him dog training, didn't you?
Sit down. Yeah, and whether he's picked something up in this field.
Sit. Sit.
Me wonder.
Stay. Right, one for you. And red. Oh, he's got the other one now, so you better have the whole one, Dougal. Sorry. Look. Dougal.
Merlin? No.
Dougal, good boy. I'll break that one in half. I can't give one and one the other. One for you, and another one for you. There you go. Off you go. Go on, away. Good boys. Good boys. Off you go. Off you go. All gone. You're very grateful, aren't you? Hey?
I've never known such a grateful dog as Dougal.
He's a lovely boy, isn't he? That's your Dougal. You're a lovely boy.
He's our bonus boy, isn't he?
Yeah.
I'll never see him. I'm
sorry that I never see him. So, yeah, as I say, happy times and sad times. But
very sad.
We've had Barney for 13 years and, again, lucky enough, we've caught him on camera. That's what I say to people.
He broke my heart, that dog, didn't he, that day?
Yeah, we both stayed with him right till the very end, which I've done it for the last, but Sharon's never done it before. And she said she would with Barney, so that's what she did. And they just go to sleep at the end of the day.
Well, it's very peaceful.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to talk about it no more.
No. Anyway, so what's going to say? I was going to say something else then.
Give them a shout out at the Safe House Shelter. We've got some lovely dogs there at the moment.
Where?
William's Safe House Shelter in Cyprus.
So, yeah, where we got these dogs from, for those of you who didn't know, we got them from the William's
Safe House Shelter.
Safe House Shelter. In Cyprus. They have got a Facebook page.
They've got some beautiful dogs there at the moment.
And I think over here, we worked out a Rottweiler over here. If we bought a Rottweiler over here, they're about £2,000 to £2,500, and a Springer Spaniel would have cost also about £2,000. Well, I'll let you know what we paid for them, because it's a flat fee what they normally charge for dogs from that place, and they charge £575 per dog. And that includes all their inoculations, that includes their pet passport, and it also includes their flight across to the UK. So you pay $575 because they're rescue dogs. Obviously, that costs money to have all that stuff. So that's all included within the.
They've got every size of dog there you want. Little dogs, big dogs, they've got them all.
Yeah, and as I say, you can only really get to them on Facebook via their group. And if you message them, they put regular videos out of the dogs they've got in stock out in Cyprus. Don't forget, as I say, these are Cyprus dogs.
Also, if you don't want a dog but you love dogs, you can sponsor the dog for £20 a month. There's a thing there where you can sponsor them. Just some beautiful dogs there. It's heartbreaking.
But when we was out there, because they do such a good job and look after the dogs so well, we actually gave them money while we was out there as well, so they could sort of buy more food or whatever and stuff like that. So, yeah.
And it's two people.
And it's not a con over there.
No.
So you're paying that money, and all that's included, as I said, the flight, everything. And we've had someone actually inquire to us.
Get back to us if you've got a dog. Let us know.
Who said that they wanted to know where we got them from, because they wanted to rescue a dog as well. So it's silly prices over here in the UK. Vet prices are silly prices over here in the UK.
Yeah, Chase's cat got run over, they think.
Well, they don't know where we got run over. It's probably come in with its paw like that. Sort of like right bent over.
He's straightened it and he's had a couple, well, a night in the vets, an operation, general anaesthetic. She says, how much do you think, mother? I went, oh, about £700, €265.
Yeah, so.
I said, at least you've done it in the right country.
And they actually said to her, you're not, when she said the price, she said, well, you're not in the UK now. So the price is. Are pretty normal out there, let's say, compared to over here. So if you don't want to get ripped off and you are looking out for a dog, look at the William Safe Shelter on Facebook, type their name in and you'll see their page come up. And I think you have to be accepted to the group first.
Yeah.
So just, what is it, ask for a friend request or something?
Emma's there always straight away. You can click the link and Emma will get back to you straight away. When I tried for...
And if you're not sure what dog you want...
She matches the dog for you. You tell her what you want, what your
if you've got kids or if you haven't got kids or you want a lap dog
match
or
you with the dog. Yeah. And loads of people on her site said you couldn't have matched us with a better dog.
Yeah.
Could they, Merlin?
Yeah. He's a funny old dog. Anyway, folks, that was just a little update. We wanted to keep you updated about poor old Barney. As I say, he did go downhill pretty quickly, but lucky enough, we've still got these two here. And they're keeping us very busy at the moment. So am I, because I'm buying stuff at the moment, buying some more lawnmowers. I've got plenty of car work to do with my car. I'm working on at the moment. You've probably seen my ST220 video. I've got another one coming out shortly. Then I've got some work on Stacey's car to do. His Astra's got a knock or a rattle at the front of that for some reason. Looks like it's under the timing chest or front timing case. So I think it might be a pulley. Or maybe a water pump, maybe it's gone on that. So that'll probably come up on Project Man's channel, to be honest with you. And also, I've probably just been out in Jimmy's car to pick up this lawnmower. And he's got a noisy, what sounds like a drive shaft to me. So that's another thing probably going to be coming up on a retro restore. So thanks very much, folks. Like and subscribe. We should have said that at the start of the video. We forgot, didn't we?
We forgot. Well, I've had Barney on my mind.
Of course you have,
so
baby.
Much.
And we'll see you in the next video. And if you want to see some more of what I'll get up to, check out my Retro Restore channel. And say ta-da. Come on, baby, get that kettle on. Thanks, folks. We'll see you in the next video. And until then, bye for now.